Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to tell you about my script Pro Setups, which you can use on TradingView.com. This script provides us with a high probability profitable setup along with the knowledge of underlying trend, which you can further combine with price action to take a trade. The script also prints ascending triangle patterns, weekly inside bars, certain candlestick patterns, and an info panel which tells you what is happening on the last candle of the chart. The script can be used by traders of all types. For instance, traders can use this script to know whether they are not buying an already extended setup. An extended setup often results in fake breakouts or have high stop loss ranges. Pullback traders or long-term investors can also use this script to enter into pullbacks. You can take a free trial of this script by going to my website and filling the form. Let's get back to the script now. The script comprises of various elements which can be segregated into primary elements, charts and candlestick patterns, and other tools which assist us in trading. Let's go one by one. The first element is the blue and red EMA clouds. The blue EMA clouds are basically the combination of multiple moving averages of shorter time duration. The red EMA cloud is basically the combination of multiple moving averages of longer time duration. Then we see blue, red and purple dots. I will explain you what are these dots later. We also see two trend bars on the top of the chart. That upper one being the higher time frame 10 and the lower one being the current time frame 10. Then we see charts and candlesticks patterns, which are ascending triangle patterns, double weekly inside bars, candlesticks patterns like bullish engulfing, bearish engulfing, double inside bar and pin bars. In other tools we have the star sign, which is nothing but the lowest ETAR of a chosen period, key moving averages such as 50 and 200 days EMAs on daily chart and 10 and 40 weeks EMAs on weekly chart, and an info panel which tells us what is happening on the last, that is the current candle of the chart. The script is based on the use of multiple moving averages. In this script, I have used exponential moving averages instead of simple moving averages. Now, I will not go into explaining what are EMAs because that is a different topic altogether. And thanks to Daryl Guppy, the Australian trader, who gave a different perspective to the use of moving averages. Guppy Multiple Moving Averages, or GMMA as it is called, is very useful in identifying trends and locating high probability profitable entry points. Now, in this chart, you can see 10 different lines which are nothing but EMAs. The blue EMA lines are of shorter time durations and the red lines are of longer time durations. The chart looks messy, I know, but if you use the Pro Setup script, these EMAs will take the form of clouds. The blue cloud that you can see on the chart now is the EMAs of shorter time durations. This blue EMA cloud that you are seeing is a combination of 5 multiple moving averages. The red cloud that you are seeing is a combination of 5 higher duration moving averages, EMAs. And since the blue EMAs use shorter time duration, they are faster to react than the red EMAs. So you will see that they will be the faster to react whenever there is any change in price. They will go up first and faster also, whereas the red EMA will go slowly than the blue EMAs. Similarly, when the price will go down, the blue cloud will come faster than the red EMAs. In many cases, you will see that the blue EMA clouds go up and down and there is no impact on the red clouds. That is basically seen in the uptrending market. Let's see this. I have removed the bars here. Or say I have removed the candles here because I want to show you only the EMA clouds. So when the price is going up, you will see that the blue clouds go up faster than the red cloud, and when the price goes down, the blue cloud is the first to come down very quickly than the red cloud. Similarly, when it goes back up again, the blue cloud is the first to go than the red cloud. On a chart, you will observe that the blue EMA cloud crosses over and crosses under the red EMA cloud multiple times. Such as this. So here the blue EMA cloud is crossing under the red EMA clouds, and over here the blue EMA cloud is crossing over the red EMA clouds. Higher the time frame, the less number of crossovers and cross-unders you will see. So on a weekly time frame, you will see very less crossovers and cross-unders, whereas on a daily or an hourly time frame, the number of crossovers and cross-unders will increase. In our script, crossovers and cross-unders are not of much importance. What is important in our script is the compression and expansion of both the set of EMAs. We will refer to compression as squeeze also wherever it is required. So the compression means the blue EMA cloud compresses, and the expansion means when it expands. So you will notice that in a strong uptrending market, the blue EMA cloud, because it is based on the shorter time duration periods, it will compress and expand faster than the red EMA clouds, such as this chart. In this chart, the blue EMA cloud compresses here and it expands, it again compresses here and again expands, one more compressor here and expands, whereas you will notice that the red EMA cloud from here till here, there is not much impact. So the blue EMA cloud is compressing and expanding multiple times, whereas there is not much impact on the red EMA cloud. We will take advantage of the compression of the blue EMA clouds. So in our script, we will wait for the blue EMAs to compress, such as here and here. We will then look to buy when the price starts to go up, so that the blue EMA cloud starts opening up, and we will look to either exit on expansion, or if we believe that the trend is strong, we will continue the trade, or maybe even add when it compresses here and starts expanding again, starts rising again. Similarly, in shorts, what we will do is that we will be looking, we will be waiting for the blue EMAs to compress or squeeze first. That will be our point of thinking. We will enter into shorts when the price starts falling, and we will look to exit either when the blue EMAs have expanded or continue the trade if the downtrend is strong. However, compression and expansion is not the only part of the strategy. There are other factors also which we need to consider, such as the current trend of the stock, any chart pattern that the stock is making, what is the level of volatility, that is the ATR, and multiple other factors which we will discuss later. So now that we know that the first point of consideration of taking a trade is a compression of the blue EMAs, our next step is to identify when are these compression happening. For this, we have dots at the bottom of the chart. The blue dots represents the compression of the blue EMA cloud. When the blue EMA cloud compresses so much that it squeezes and the cloud appears very thin, the blue dots appear at the bottom of the chart like this. When the red EMA cloud compresses and appears very thin, the red dot appears at the bottom of the chart. When both blue and red EMA cloud compresses, we get purple dots at the bottom of the chart. Our main point of consideration will be the blue dots, because here is where we will be looking at the trend of the stock, the chart pattern, if any, it is making, and the level of volatility, such as ATR, the key moving averages like 50 or 200 days moving averages, and other factors. Let's now move on to our next primary element of the script, which is the trend. So the breadth and the direction of the red EMA clouds tells us about the direction of the trend as well. If the red EMA clouds are wide and moving upwards, we will be in a strong uptrend. If the movement of the red EMA cloud is down and it is wide, we will be in a downtrend. If it is narrow, we will be in a changing trend. Let's see this on the chart now. The script shows you trend on the top of the chart, like this one. This is the chart of Mahindra & Mahindra and Indian Company. The red color shows downtrend and favors shorting opportunities. The green color represents uptrend and favors buying opportunities. Yellow color signifies changing trend. As you can see, there are two trend bars, this and this. On a weekly time frame chart, the color of both the bars will be same because they are of the same time frame, which is the weekly chart. On a daily chart, the color of the two trend bars will be different because the upper one will represent the trend of the weekly chart, which is the higher time frame trend, and the lower one will represent the trend of the current time frame chart, which is the daily trend. On an hourly chart, the upper time frame trend will be of the daily time frame and the lower one will be of the current time frame, which is the hourly chart. So except for weekly time frame, the upper bar will represent the trend of the higher time frame and the lower bar will represent the trend of the current time frame trend. So how can these trend bars help you? Well, you must have heard a lot of quotes on trend following, such as the trend is your friend until it ends, or do not try to catch the falling knife. Half of the battle is won if one is aware of the underlying trend. As a trader, it is prudent for us to go along with the trend and do not fight it. Yet most of the traders keep on making the same mistake of going against the trend. If you are planning to buy something, but the trend bar is continuously red, that is a downtrend, you might want to resist buying here unless you are a value investor and very good in spotting bottoms. On the other hand, if the red bar changes to yellow, it indicates change in trend. Here you might want to consider buying if there are other conditions also which are being met. A change from yellow to green is a good signal in most of the cases. If you are buying when the trend is green, it means you are going along with the trend. But why two trend bars? Well, there are many traders who do not want to see any other time frame other than the time frame than they are currently looking at. So if they are trading based on the daily time frame, they want to see only the daily time frame. If they are trading on the basis of hourly charts, they do not want to see what is happening on the daily or even the weekly charts. Yet I believe that the knowledge of the higher time frame trend helps you in making good trades. For example, you bought something when the daily time frame trend is uptrend. At the same time, the weekly trend is also showing you green color, which is uptrend. Will it not give you confidence? On the other hand, if you buy something when the daily trend is in uptrend but the weekly trend is red, you might get stopped out because the price might reverse and continue in the same direction of the weekly trend. Here you might incur your stop loss. The current time frame trend bar, that is a lower trend bar, enables you to make sure that you are trading in the direction of the trend. The higher time frame trend, that is the upper bar, lets you know the direction of the trades in which the traders with a time horizon longer than you are trading in. Please note that shifting of the trend bar color from one to another is not a signal of buying or shorting a stock. We also wait for the setup to come to us in the form of blue dots at the bottom of the chart before we consider taking a trade or not. By default, the chart shows you both the trend bars, but by going to settings, you can choose whether you want to see any trend bar or only the current time frame trend bar. Now, till here, I have told you about the primary elements of the script, which are blue and red EMA clouds, blue, red and purple dots which appear at the bottom of the chart, and two trend bars which comes on the top of the chart. The other tools of the script, which are charts and candlesticks patterns, and other tools like an info panel and key moving averages, assist a trader in taking a trade. I will be discussing about charts and candlesticks patterns and other tools in my next video. In this video, I would like to show you some examples of the trades that can be taken with the help of primary elements. So let's move on to examples now. Now this is the chart of Asian Paints and you are looking at its weekly time frame chart. You can see two trend bars on the top of the chart. Since this is a weekly chart, both the trend bars represent weekly trend. You can also see blue dots at the bottom of the chart. Now the appearance of the blue dots is the first step where we analyze a trade. Here we can see that the stock is in continuous uptrend as represented by the green bars on the top of the chart. In fact, it was red in 2008-09 financial crisis, but since then it has always been in green. In fact, it turned yellow sometimes but soon turned into green instead of turning into red. And every time the blue dots came at the bottom of the chart, we had the opportunity to take a pullback trade. Coming back to the blue dots, it is always better to have more than one blue dot. After we see these blue dots, we want to see the stock to trade in a narrow range. In other words, the candles should make a sort of rectangle before we take a trade. And we take a trade when the price breaks out of that narrow range. Let's see a couple of blue dots here. Let's see this blue dot only. So our stock, when it was showing us blue dots over here, I'm talking about these blue dots, it was also trading in a narrow range. We can make a sort of rectangle here like this and keep our entry above this rectangle when the price breaks out of this rectangle line. So our entry here will be somewhere around 160 odd levels. We will keep our stop loss at around 1090. We will enter the trade at around 1160-1165. We can exit the stock when the EMA lines have expanded, or we can continue the trade if we believe that the uptrend is strong. Let's see one more example here. There are a lot of blue dots which are appearing here. Here we can see that the stock is trading in a narrow range, so we can make a rectangle Here we will keep our entry here when this breaks above this rectangle line at 906. We can keep our stop loss at around 840 levels. Our entry will be above 906, say at around 910. We can exit the stock when the blue EMA lines have expanded, or continue the trade depending upon the trend. I know we cannot exit here, but we can decide whether we want to trail the trade by keeping some breakdown line. We might exit here when the EMAs have expanded, or when it starts falling and falls below the lower low of certain days. Let's see this example. We have only one dot here, but we can still make a kind of rectangle. Here our entry can be above this price, 555. Our exit, because of stop loss, can be 503. Now this is a slightly high range, which will result in around 9 to 10% stop loss, so we have to be cautious here. So that's why I like more narrow range where our stop loss is not more than 6 or 7%. Here when we are seeing a lot of blue dots with star signs, which means that the ATR is at the lowest levels, we can make a rectangle here. We did not get the immediate entry here, we got our entry around 4 to 5 weeks later over here. In fact, our rectangle also expanded, so our entry would have been at around this level, 501, with then stop loss of 460 levels, again a slightly higher stop loss level of around 8% or 9%. Yeah, so that's how we take our buy trade. The blue dots at the bottom of the chart gives us a pattern, gives us a setup. We look at the trend. Here the trend is green. We take the trade by price action when the price breaks out of the narrow range, and exit when the EMA lines have expanded, or keep on or continue with the trade if the trend is strong. Let's see the example of Mahindra and Mahindra. Remember that we are looking at the weekly charts right now, where both the trend bars are of same color. So here we have the downtrend in the form of red colors in the trend bars above. We get a blue dots here. Our price is trading in a narrow range, so we can make a kind of rectangle here. Let's zoom it. Our short will be signaled when the price breaks down below the rectangle at around 529 levels. We can keep our stop loss above this, which will be at around 589. We can exit the stock when the stop loss is hit or when the EMA lines have expanded. We can also continue the trade if we believe that the stock will keep on falling further. Yeah, let's see the green trend here. We got the blue dots here when the stock was in clear uptrend. Here also we can make a sort of rectangle. Our entry would have been above this rectangle when the price breaks above 750 levels. Our stop loss would have been below this at 705, a trade of stop loss not more than 6-7%. So our entry would have been at around 750. We would have either exited the trade when the EMA lines had expanded, or continue the trade if we believe that the trend will be green. Yeah, let's now go to another stock and see. I like this chart because it was in a narrow range over here. You can see the blue dots here. It also came with the star signals, which means the ATR was at the lowest level. We can make a sort of rectangle over here. Here also our entry would have been above this at above 385. Our stop loss would have been below 353. Now we could have exited the stock much later. I mean, in fact, it gave a gain of over 80-90% in a matter of less than a year, 44 weeks. Let's see a couple of more examples here. So here we have the blue dots. Yes, we could have made an easy rectangle here. Our entry would have been above
321 with a stop loss of 296. Now here the stop loss is around 7-8%, which is fine. You could have exited the stock when the EMAs have expanded or continued the trade. In fact, long term traders or investors or trend followers, they can enter the stock here also. So this script can help you in trend following as well. Let's see its daily charts now. This is the daily chart of Relaxo Footwears. We saw a lot of blue dots over here, but here the daily trend was red and the weekly trend was green. Now since this is a daily chart, you see two trend bars, the lower one being the daily time frame, which is the current time frame trend, and the upper one being the weekly time frame trend. You can make a kind of rectangle here when these blue dots were appearing. You would have entered the stock here. You would have entered only because the weekly trend is also green. Here, the daily trend is reversing into green and exited the stock at 592. Our stop loss range would have been around 7-8%. Now here, we have the purple dots here. Purple dots is a combination of blue dot and red dot. This means that purple dots includes blue dots, so we can consider this also. Now the combination of blue and red dots results in a purple dots, means that the trade can be very sharp. It can give a very quick return as well as it can turn into a quick loss also. Here also we can make a kind of rectangle. Our entry here would have been above 439 levels. Our stop loss would have been below this 415. And we take a long trade, could have resulted in an easy 75% gain in less than half an year. This is a daily chart. Let's see its competitor Bata. Okay, so here we are looking at couple of blue dots over here. The trend of the daily time frame is also red, though it might be turning into green soon. The weekly trend has also turned from red to yellow and might be turning into green. We can avoid these kind of trades if you are not confident. We can only consider taking a trade when the both trend bars are green or either of them is green, especially the higher time frame trend and the daily time frame trend is yellow. So we might have considered a trade when these blue dots were coming, because here the upper time frame trend is green and the lower is also green. Let's see one more example now. Bajaj Finance. So let's examine these blue dots. When we first got this blue dot on this candle, our range would have been this. It did not break out of the range, but then we kept on getting these blue dots and the stock made a new range of this rectangle. So the stock was continuously trading for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days in this range, a range of 3%. So our entry price would have been above this at 4200 levels. Our exit would have been below 4067 in case of stop loss, indicating a stop loss of 3% levels. And depending upon what is our target, my target is to have at least 3x of my stop loss levels. So if I am playing for a 3% stop loss, I want to have a gain of at least 9-10%. So my target level would have been at 4200, my target level would have been around 4600 to 4700 levels, and if the stock reaches there, I would have taken a partial exit. The stock went to 4800 levels, in fact it went to 4700 levels in a matter of 14 days. So I would have taken a partial exit here, because the stock also shows that the blue EMAs have already expanded, and my full exit would have been at a lower low of say this level, whenever the stock would have fallen below this one, so maybe at this candle. In any trading strategy, our aim should be to minimize the stop loss and maximize the gain. I like to enter into a stock when the range is very narrow. Here, in this example, the range was not more than 4%. It was only 3%. So here, even if I incurred a loss, my loss would not have been more than 3-3.5% or 4% max if I was careless in exiting out of the trade because of the loss. In any trading strategy, our aim should be to minimize the stop loss and maximize the gains. If I'm taking a trade based on weekly chart, my stop loss can exceed to around 7-8% even if the range is narrow. So on a trade based on a weekly chart, if my stop loss is around 7-8%, I would like to see a gain of minimum 20-25% where I will start taking my partial exits. If I'm taking a trade on the basis of daily time frame chart, my stop loss will not be more than 3-4%, in which case I will be targeting a profit of minimum 10-15%, which is 3x of my stop loss amount. If I'm taking a trade based on hourly time frame charts where I still get blue dots, my stop loss will not be more than 2-2.5%, and I will be attempting to take a profit of at least 9-10%. So in all cases, my attempt is to minimize the stop loss and maximize the gains. Let's see these purple dots. Now purple dots also include blue dots. Purple dots are formed when we get blue dots as well as the red dots together. Let's see if we could have taken a trade here. So when these purple dots started coming, my range would have been this. I'm talking about the first purple dot. I'm not talking about the other dots because when I got the first purple dot, I did not know whether the next dot will also be the same or not. So here my entry would have been above 3320 levels and my stop loss would have been 3015. Here my stop loss is more than 9.5 or 10%. I would have definitely not considered a trade here, definitely not. So even if these purple dots were there, my range would have been this, again a very high range, so I would not have taken a trade here, even though the stock went up pretty high and would have given me a gain of 17% in quick time. But no, I would not have considered a trade here since the range was very high.
So this ends part one of the video where I discuss the various primary elements of the script, which are the blue and red EMA clouds, the blue, red and purple dots which appear at the bottom of the chart whenever the setup happens, and the two 10 bars which comes on the top of the chart. We wait for the blue dots to appear before we even analyze the chart. Then we check the underlying trend of the stock and wait for the stock to have a narrow range. Finally, we take a trade when the price breaks out of that narrow range. The setup can be applied on all time frames. The process is the same. If you are a new trader, I suggest you to start with weekly time frame charts and gradually move to daily and hourly time frames. Now, as a trader, you will be interested in knowing the names of all those stocks which are showing the blue dots. For this, I have a Telegram channel which sends you the names of all the companies which are forming blue dots on daily and weekly time frames. This list is sent to the users every day at the close of market hours. I also send a list of all the stocks which are forming blue dots on hourly time frames, which comes after every hour. This hourly list should ideally be used by very active traders. In the next part of the video, I will discuss with you how the script prints certain chart and candlestick patterns like ascending triangle patterns, weekly inside bars and engulfing patterns, how you can use the ATR, certain key moving averages and an info panel for your trading purposes. If you are interested in the script, you can go to my website and fill the form. Once I get your request, I will give you the access and also invite you to join my Telegram channel. Also, please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel because I will be putting more videos on how to use this script and will also be listing out some stocks which are forming the setups as and when they are formed. Thank you so much for listening. Jai Hind.